The potential for flooded roadways as well as damaging winds will continue as we go into the overnight hours. We have already seen some areas of flooding in western Cumberland County, and that will continue again overnight. But wind damage, we'll look for that between 12 to 4 a.m. Thankfully, it is a very low threat, but still within the realm of possibility. We've seen some roadway flooding in western Cumberland County because we've seen over an inch so far. Deerfield has had 1.03 inches. As you guys should get out towards Greenwich, we're near an inch and a quarter. Philadelphia is at 1.17. But look what happens as you go further to the east. Not even a drop in EHT, Long Beach Island, or Atlantic City. Now, that will change during the overnight hours. We are expecting periods of steady, heavy rain everywhere. We could even see a rumble of thunder. If we do, then we're talking about the potential for damaging winds. Again, a low threat, but something to keep in mind. Then from the early morning hours through about 9 a.m. on Wednesday, it's these off and on showers again, and then most of our day Wednesday will be dry. Let's take a look at our future radar. This is 8 p.m. tonight. You notice that steady, heavy band of rain trying to work its way eastward, and it will. Now this is 11 a.m., 2 a.m. That's when our heaviest rain should be, and then by 9 o'clock, we are done with our rain. Here's a look at the rainfall to come. Generally between a half inch to an inch everywhere. Some places could see a little bit more than that. But again, remember, we've already seen an inch already in western Cumberland County. So if we do pick up another inch like this model is showing in Stowe Creek, yes, we could see some more areas of roadway flooding. As you get out towards Long Beach Island and the shore, lower totals here. Now remember, yesterday I was saying, don't pay attention exactly to these rainfall maps just yet. And that's the reason why for today. They can change a little bit. For this evening, temperatures will slide through the 70s into the 60s. Oh, so slowly. We have that areas of rain around. That south-southeasterly wind is helping put a floor on how far our temperatures could fall overnight. So we will be 5 to 10 degrees above average for the overnight hours, but the steady heavy rain is the main story, and we will watch out for a damaging wind gust. Now here's a look at our dew point as we go overnight into tomorrow, because we're going from summer to fall in that department. Anything above 70 degrees is sticky, and we're going to have some areas of that this evening. And as we go into tomorrow, look at this. You already start to see some dry air after about 2 a.m. And that's just straight up dry air. And that will continue to fall as we go into the day. Look at 2 p.m. on Wednesday, only in the low 50s, and then even a couple of 40s probably in the Pine Barrens as we go into our Wednesday evening. So we're going from summer to fall for our last day of September. Now here's our mid-level pattern as we go forward in time throughout the week. Notice those blues. That is coming our way. Will kind of be seasonable for the next couple of days, but then once we get towards the weekend, this comes in, and then we're talking about temperatures that are going to be awfully chilly here. But again, not today. We will see as we go into Wednesday, we'll see showers through about 9 a.m. and then mostly sunny sky, then just turning sunny for the afternoon as those dew points do fall. High temperatures will be around 70 degrees. Daytime planners looking good for most outdoor activities. And as we go into our shore and mainland 7-day forecast, let's show you what's going on the mainland. Temperatures will fall into the 60s for the weekend. We'll look for a couple of showers on Friday, and then as we go into Saturday, that will be our best day of the weekend. Sunday should be dry during the day, and then at night into Monday, we're watching for another system. For right now, we'll say it's mostly dry, but periods of rain will be in the realm of possibility. We'll be back with you at 6:30 tomorrow morning with the latest in South Jersey weather. We'll talk to you more about this fall air to come and even a look at the fall foliage throughout the state. You can follow me on social media for the latest, or you can always come back to our website at thepressofac.com/weather.